can't wait to see this one unfold.
Well, let's see here. It's Christian Carlson to start it off. Best of five, love all.
One, love.
Ripping backhand here. That little acknowledgement. Nice receive here down the line. Lin Shedong. Good adjustment here to keep Christian Carlson less comfortable on his third ball attack.
Yeah, he's a different kind of physique, isn't he, Lin Shedong? No, he's only 17, but...
One, two.
Such an explosive matchup, isn't it?
Yeah, it's. I think of Christian Carlson. You and I talked about it at dinner the other day. If the Swedish team, and they're all big and strong, were to wrestle, Christian Carlson would be my pick.
Yeah.
That said, the power that we see on the step around here, Lin Shedong just exploding and not even a chance to get the racket up. Watch how quick he turns.
He reads the game so, so well. It's not all power. There's a lot of tactical nous that he has too.
Speaking of tactics, deception right there on the serve. Heavy underspin from Christian Carlson for an outright point on the serve. This receive, too. I mean, that ball looked like it was a finger breaker to even go for the attack, let alone win it outright.
The awareness off the half long is actually probably the thing that impresses me most of professional table tennis players. It looks barely attackable at all, and yet they're able to play a full stroke off it. Brave.
Three, four.
Because we saw Carlson in the semi-final of the European Champs have to withdraw, cut his hand open, going for the half long against Jorgic.
Yeah, remember it well. One of two times he had to, well, finish an event that he was playing quite well in. That is unbelievable. Unbelievable. It doesn't count. The ruling is, I was reading the comments section on a recent social media post, a perfect shot, and it blocks the next ball. What are the odds? This is like one in a... I don't think I've ever seen that in my life.
I've never seen that either, Adam.
Amazing. Just to clarify, the ruling is the racket must be in control of the hand when it is contacting the ball. It could be two hands, it could be one hand, it could be either hand, and if it hits the hand between the wrist and the fingertips of the hand that is holding the racket, fine. But if you let go of the racket, the point's over. You can't hit the ball anymore.
You know this rule a little bit more than me. What if your fingertip was touching the bat as it makes contact with the ball? Is that allowed?
You mean a double hit?
No, say you extend it, but your finger's touching the bat as it makes contact with the ball. Would that still count because part of your hand is touching the racket?
Only if you're in control of the racket. If your hand is in control, then the hand is acceptable. Beautiful backhands here. Lin Shedong fighting to even out the scoreline.
It's not like a Haramoto, for example, or say a Zhu Yingbin. He's not showing every point, Lin Shedong. He's selective about when he gets vocal. He's a little bit different in that way. Actually quite a quiet player most of the time.
Quiet guy.
Seven,
if you see
five.
Him, I mean, you and I have the opportunity. We see these players around all the time, dining hall and whatnot. But, yeah, quite a reserved character in general. The humility, I think there have been a lot of very humble players. I mean, look at world number one. Fan Zhendong is leaps and bounds above the rest by points right now, but you wouldn't know it from the way he talks.
Not at all. Not at all.
Seven, six.
Good look there on the receive. This one, a little bit more room there for Lin Shedong to spin it comfortably. Again, a serve that a lot of players would have trouble with, but Lin Shedong quite comfortable on that receive game.
Incredible.
Nice combination there. Carlson stretching his opponent deep to the forehand on the counter and then finding the open backhand.
Nice point construction from Carlson, and Lin Shedong will be aware of how to play Carlson. I mean, Carlson's a world champion in his own right in men's doubles. He's beaten Wang Chu-Chin before, notably. And he actually nearly beat Ma Long, I think. He was 2-0 up in a match a few years back.
Nearly is a very interesting word with Ma Long.
Good point.
It is funny. how that works, but that is an impressive lead. Either way, this one's tight, and for a player who was beaten 3-1 not long ago, Christian Carlsen is going to be looking to get in and take this first game. And to keep his confidence high, keep pressure on Lin Shedong. Nice save there. I thought after the ball was popped up, watch Christian Carlsen here. Beautiful attack, gets right back into the backhand corner and moves back into the table to follow up for the finish. Second time we've seen an outright service point with deceptively heavy underspin from K2.
Yeah, and it's into the forehand, so because it's so backspin, it's tough to even attempt a flick. The table surface is in the way, so you can't drop the racket back with the wrist.
Three game points now for Christian Carlsen. Good placement here on the receive from Lin Shedong.
That ball goes and I'm walking out of here. A seatbelt shot attempt from Carlsen, but yeah, really nice placement from Lin Shedong.
8-10.
See what he's made of.
Second time we've seen that stretch that Timo Boll made quite famous. The Borussia Dusseldorf, the Coffee Brothers out here stretching out that back. And a tight serve, the attempted flick. It's two game points saved with one more serve left. And a timeout now in game number one. This is quite an early timeout, a little conversation. We'll see back fresh and ready, Christian Carlsen, game point. And he managed to get aggressive on the receive, and Lin Shedong not bothered, didn't flinch, and brings it back two times with interest. Look at the shots here. The power in the replays.
It just goes to show you don't need a big stroke to generate the power.
So three in a row for Lin Shedong there. He saved three game points, alternating serves now. And the fourth point in a row. If Lin Shedong wins one more point with Wang Hao in the corner, he will have a 1-0 lead in an opponent with no timeouts left.
That is such a gutsy receive, and it had to be high spin and high quality because you left the wide backhand exposed.
Good thing they both saw that, although the umpire as well and the assistant, everybody was clear on that. What a turnaround from 7-10 down, the 17-year-old against world number 21, Christian Carlsen. Continuing his momentum here, the sixth point in a row, Lin Shedong.
Oh, wow. I mean, even though it was a late, you can see how much backspin was on that. Logo just became an absolute blur.
Now that's tough. If you've had a, I hate to say slit wrist, but a cut wrist from the corner of the table in a match in recent history, and someone serves you that ball, you're going to be very, very hesitant to be overly aggressive and ambitious.
Yeah, it's going to be a few flashbacks, right? A few demons creeping in.
Him and Tomokazu Harimoto, it takes time. In a lot of sports, you have an injury here and there, but you still have to get back in the ring or the box, whatever it is. Well, now that backhand punishing on the receive. Beautiful stroke out here.
It just looks like he has an extra second on the ball, even when he doesn't win Shedong.
So seven of the last 8 points for the 17-year-old who was down three game points in the first game. This is incredible play. The in and out of Lin Shedong, the continued persistence from the backhand corner of Christian Carlsen. Inside out forehand, still didn't finish the point.
Incredible. Yeah. I like the facial recognition of the quality there of Carlsen from Lin Shedong.
Bottle challenge served deep to the backhand. And again, if you're a little newer to table tennis, we call it the bottle challenge serve. WTT had this challenge where you try to serve the ball around the bottle down the line. It's a common serve that Lin Wenru, left-handed players, like to do to righties and vice versa. Christian Carlsen down by two out of the first towel break. Rocket backhand, but it takes more than one, the combination play from Carlsen.
Carlson's one of those players where you could tell he was playing even if you had your eyes shut. There it is again. Insane. Never seen that before. For that serve again, the wide half long, very aggressive with the serves, Lin Shidong. You can see the intent and purpose of them.
The fact that he can block that opening Christian Carlsen forehand is crazy. You talked about it earlier, his read of the game, his understanding of not only the table and the ball, but the opponent and what to play is just mature. He's wise beyond his years.
Yeah, for sure. That's as impressive as his shot-making ability for me.
Nice change here. Christian Carlsen moved more central on the table to change it up. Lin Shidong saying, okay, clever play. Tip my hat to you, good sir. Second time now, Christian Carlsen might have found a new home for the start of this serve. Little table cleaning, little maintenance, some room service. Just asking permission. Takes care of it himself, I like that. He's good around the house, not afraid to do the dishes when he needs.
Yeah, a bit of DIY goes a long way.
Should have seen him in here doing the lights the other day. Right into the middle, that crossover point. Now, can you talk to us a little bit about why a player won't go deep to the corners early in the point?
I guess it's more comfortable to block or counter. Whereas if you hit into the middle, your body's in the way, right? So it's harder to be able to create that full extension or have the distance from the arm that's required to play a good stroke. You can return Carlsen's hot forehands when he's in that kind of mood.
But this was as quick and painless as can be. Touch receive there, and Christian Carlsen, you shouldn't have to worry about a shot that aggressive on the parallel coming back to finish the point outright.
Six,
not easy to do from baseline on the table, but a quality push.
Yeah, really loose wrist.
Not easy to serve short with topspin. Now, in case you were curious about where the yellow card came from, as mentioned before, I think we got a little surprise for you.
Looked like Carlsen wanted a slow brush up to then be able to counter, and he got the slow brush up off the half long.
So that was the yellow card moment right there. In case you were curious, visual proof for where that yellow card came from. You don't see too many players throwing the rackets and not getting warned about it. What? We have to see this again.
Hang on a sec.
Hold up.
Oh my.
He never touched
goodness.
The ball on the first swing, and he followed up and hit it. One time, I just saw a video of this happening internationally.
Yeah.
This is unbelievable. Look
one
more
did
time.
Did he touch it? Did he touch it?
Swing and a
no.
miss. Follow-up attack.
Oh, my goodness.
Unbelievable. Christian Carlsen wins
it's
the point.
Point. It's his point.
This is
Christian's.
Incredible. This is, look at this shot. And he catches it.
I've never seen that, Adam. I've never seen that on a WTT table.
To witness things like this for the first time, Christian Carlsen, not intentional, but he had to keep playing. And this will be a very, very learning moment for Lin Shidong. Christian Carlsen saying, wait, we need to correct the score here. They're still waiting to catch up on the scoreboard. Wow.
That is cat-like reactions from Christian Carlsen.
Wow. I'd only seen this for my first time recently in a much less important match, and it brings it to within 1 point.
Eight,
the best way to respond.
Yeah.
Lin Shidong, that would have been a really tough way to come back and talk to Wong Hao. Between the racket throw, the one where he played the ball and then it came back on the racket, and what we just saw, I mean, this is just an unbelievably rare, just so many unusual highlights. No, he did not. That right there is unbelievable. Disrespectful from near the ground. Lin Shidong. A lot of fun to rewatch that moment there in the replay. Christian Carlsen down 0-2. Good capitalization there from the back of the table. Lin Shidong. Not a lot he could do to recover that one.
Carlsen is capable of coming back against a Chinese national team player. He did it against Wang Chuqin at the Summer Series a couple seasons ago.
Was he down 0-2?
I believe so.
One love.
I'll double check just to make sure.
Okay, sounds good. I'll wait right here and enjoy the match. Service warning.
Indian drive. Inside drive. Your board is inside drive. Please outside.
So I guess they're warning him on the toss. The ball must be tossed from behind the table and contacted for that matter. Perfect placement there. Just testing the bravery and the wrists of Lin Shidong on the other side. It's all fair play. This is what the half-long serve is all about. No one's trying to injure the other player. They're just trying to get into the point. Out of this world. A push from deep on the table. I don't know if the fans can appreciate, really. They appreciate it clearly, but the level of play here. Passive shot, medium chop, and a short side right to the baseline. That's a killer ball.
He's in that mood, Adam, that he was in against Felix Lebrun in the semi-final stage of Goa, where he was just hitting bombs left, right, and center off any kind of ball.
Yeah, I remember watching that one, like many table tennis fans from home, and thinking to myself, it's unbelievable the level of shot making, the confidence that Lin Shidong has, just this fearless play. The first towel break, and it's continuing the way the first two games have, despite a bit of back and forth. Some crucial moments, some very interesting, could have gone either way moments. The 2/3 of the points so far, the 17-year-old. It's really just amazing how much it takes to finally win a point against Lin Shidong. We've seen it on many occasions from Christian Carlsen, but that doesn't win it. It actually comes back with heavy side. Even in the replay of that fast backhand, there was heavy side with the top.
It wasn't far from going up. Just to clarify as well, I must admit I made a mistake. Carlsen was not 2-0 down to Wang Chuqin at the Summer Series. Must have been thinking about another match, but he did beat Wang Chuqin.
Impressive nonetheless, Wang Chuqin, one of the most unbeaten players in the world. Lin Shidong working his way up to that level within the Chinese national team. Heavy push here. It's tough again if you haven't played competitive table tennis before. The amount, it's just how important the spin is, the amount of spin a player can generate with this professional equipment and years of practice is incredible.
Oh, yeah. Taste of the medicine there with the wide half long.
Yeah, and this one was shorter than we've seen in a while, just dangling off the side before he did it right near the corner, Christian Carlsen. So 4 points in a row out of the first towel break. Christian Carlsen with very strong string of points here. Some incredible momentum in a must-win situation. Can't afford to drop another game in this match.
12-7.
The way he grips the racket, Carlsen's slightly different. Looks like the three fingers are fairly low down. Good. Very good. Chipping away, Lin Shidong.
So the second towel break here. Just to clarify, in terms of grips, we've seen a variety of grips. You're saying that Christian Carlsen's racket, it's almost like he grips it lower on the handle as opposed to hugging the blade itself so much?
Yeah.
Right.
A5.
So far, Lin Shedong hasn't really found the answers to that short to the forehand serve. He's looking to get in there with the backhand, just trying out a variety of things. So 6 of the last 8 points for Christian Carlsen.
Let A5.
The recovery is amazing to me. He's still a threat from that far back.
Yeah, I watch Christian Carlsen. It's so relatable when someone's giving you these heavy topspin shots and you're on the backhand trying to stay on top of the bounce. Just a lot less sort of room there for movement on the backhand, the way the forehand has so much versatility. But this backhand, Lin Shedong, the explosive shots again, he's dangerous.
It's like Carlsen's feeling in multi-ball.
Does have that feel. Wow. Big backhand comes out in a crucial moment. Christian Carlsen gets the two serves back, 2 points away from getting his first game on the scoreboard. The table tennis fans know this, but multi-ball, just practice, like batting practice. One ball after another, and the player keeps ripping and recovering. Perfect touch, the soft hands from the big man, and Christian Carlsen sets up 3 game points. Wasn't enough in game number 1. Will it be here?
If he can't convert here, we'll ask serious questions of himself. Just kick the top of the net as well, I think. Still, good shot selection. Oh, the demons come in again, the whispers.
Lin Shedong has shown us nerves of steel in game number 1. Maturity from a 17-year-old that's battling against years of experience. With Jorgen Persson there in the Swedish coaching position. A world champ coaching, a world champ in men's doubles. 2 game points left for Carlsen.
Seems like Lin Shedong is bringing out that shovel serve with a bit of topspin and playing it into the middle when he's facing game points.
Wow.
8-10.
That right there, a fast long serve, changed it up at the last moment. Good deception, but let once again. And the slower spinny one here, Lin Shedong. It's just breaking the timing here. While he's got the power, he's also got the mind, the wherewithal, to slow it down and spin it sometimes.
Yeah, more of a divisive, mile long light back on there.
2 game points saved. 1 more, Lin Shedong. 3 in a row, and listen to the crowd. Christian Carlsen has had his toes on the line of a few games so far, and Lin Shedong has been his worst nightmare on the other side. Deuce alternating serves until one player has a 2-point lead.
Red.
This could be the last serve for Christian Carlsen, so he's going to have to make it count. Well, now, handcuffed once again. This is one that you just want to watch over and over. There was so much pressure in this moment. What improvisation there.
Yeah, a forehand chop block.
Here it is from under the net, right there near the table. Forehand chop block, Christian Carlsen leaving a lot of side spin on. Lin Shedong not bothered. Match points. And Lin Shedong for the second time in this match with 5 straight points from 7-10 down. And Christian Carlsen nods his head to say, well played.